Whenever we have a occasion, we say Assalamu alaikum and good morning or good afternoon. Okay, I'm still Malaysian. So the paper about the determinants of ASEAN 5 real effective exchange rate again is the UK pound. ASEAN actually is an association for East Asian nations, a combination of around 10 countries, but we have the founding members. Only are five, Malaysia, Singapore, and Indonesia, Thailand, and Philippines. There are other few countries like Vietnam, Laos, Brunei, they joined very late. Even Brunei became a country in 1980s. So it's very difficult to combine these in the study. So we only have the five ASEAN countries. And the main author is also a PhD student. I wish he can make it, but unfortunately he didn't make it. Okay, so this is the objective of the paper. This paper presents an empirical analysis of long run and short run forcing variables of purchasing power for ASEAN currencies against the UK pound and the real effect on exchange rate. Actually, let us to go directly to the topic. Exchange rate is very important. Actually, there is a model called three gaps model. If you want to have linked this study to sustainability, the three gaps model are exchange rate, investment, and saving. And the exchange rate is very important actually for sustainability of economic growth or sustainability of the community or the country. If I get back to financial crisis of East Asia, or they call it Asian financial crisis in 1997. The countries like Indonesia was developing very fast. It's going to be almost a developed nation. And unfortunately, because of a financial crisis, political struggle came and the country backward so much. The strong man, although he's a dictator, so hard to, but he was managed to bring the country to a good development. They are producing everything. But the problem is population. And because of financial crisis, and most Asian, East Asian countries lost the value, almost 50 and some countries 100%. I remember the Malaysian currency from 2.5 against $1 to the $5, five ringgit, almost 100% losses. Then they control the system, and then the became a 3.8, almost lost 30 something percent. It also applied to Korea, supported by the World Bank. It's the only country that brought the money and they returned back the money, South Korea. As a result of that, the country backwarded, all the development backwarded also. They came with a very weak system, a blind president, and then another lady, she has no experience, and just now they got the right president. So, exchange rate is very important also for purchasing power. When the currency reduce, our purchasing power will become very low. And our salary, I think we have this experience in Sudan, and we know it better when our currency declines so much. Okay? Actually, the methodology used for this study is a lot of equations in the paper. To apply this, and the data from 1991 to 2006 is a quarterly data, and the data is available in IMF online data. Then we use the something called autoregressive distributed lag, and the advantage of autoregressive distributed lag is the data is stationary. There is a stationarity problem normally. Those who involve in econometric analysis, they know what does mean by stationarity and co-integration. So using the autoregressive distributed lag will help to make the data stationary and will overcome all the problem of co-integration and unit root test problem and all these things. Okay, so we go to the main findings. In the short run, the impact of variable have different impact during the sub period of the study. The results suggest that the domestic money supply for Malaysia, domestic interest rate and foreign interest rate for Indonesia, domestic money supply and term of trade for Philippines, foreign interest rate for Thailand and foreign interest rate and net foreign assets for Singapore respectively have the highest significant short-run forcing variables for purchasing power parity. Purchasing power parity actually is the ability of people to purchase and showing how much you can purchase with your money. In this paper also, the exchange rate model applied to explore the forcing factors that determine the real exchange rate to the ASEAN countries. However, there are many scholars here. They have different views and different findings in this study. So there are comprehensive discussion of, if you are really interested in this area, you can find the details in the paper, which is in the conference proceeding. And there's also a lot of advantages of using the autoregressive distribution like that I explained before. It can be applied regardless of the stationary properties of the variables in the sample, and also it allows for inferences on long run estimate, which is not possible under alternative co-integration procedures. So if you are really interested in this, and if you are really using the time series, you need to know these issues. And the first step in the ARDL procedure is outlined by is to test the long run significance of the dependent variable by computing the F statistic. I think this is all the statistical analysis and econometric analysis. You can get the details in the paper. And the main advantage of this procedure are, firstly, there is no prior into exogenous division of variables. Secondly, no zero restrictions are imposed. And finally, there is no strict economic theory within which the model is grounded. And the ARDL approach also allows to identify long-run and short-run dynamic explanatory variable on dependent variable. So this also has a relation with the econometric analysis, how to avoid the problems associated with estimating the time series data, especially the monthly data, because the monthly data has very high frequency. It has very high frequency, and then it has a lot of statistic and econometric problems should be considered in order to have a valid result. So we go to the conclusion and the result. I try to make it very short because the paper is very complicated, and actually I believe most of you have no background of econometrics, so I don't want to complicate the things. I make it very short. In this paper, we examine the long run and short run forcing variable of domestic interest rate, foreign interest rate, inflation rate, domestic money supply, net foreign asset, terms of trade, and real gross domestic product upon real exchange rate of ASEAN countries against UK pound. So we have found that the long run and short run forcing variable of purchasing power parity for ASEAN 5 differ due to their different economic environment and determined with this study of Professor Mansour. He's very famous in this area. Actually, ASEAN are different than UK, and accordingly, the findings are different, and even the purchasing power is totally different. I give you a small example. In UK here, there are many benefits. In East Asia, even in Japan or Korea, if you don't work there, there are no benefits. So you have to work. You have no money, then you have nothing. So this is the reason the purchasing power is very important, your ability to purchase and engaging in the employment. Here the story is totally different. If you don't work, maybe you can get a lot of benefits. At least you can survive. So the estimated long run parameters of ASEAN 5 exchange rate model show that most of the variables carry the correct expected signs. This has a relation with the findings. Okay. And finally, our empirical results are also in line with the World Bank researchers, who found that the developing economies in general are heterogeneous. It means they have different story and different purchasing power and different issues related to exchange rate and so on. Thus, the long run forcing variable of PP should differ according to country's economic environment. The results are also similar to the empirical findings of these people. So the policymakers in this respect, ASEAN 5 economists need to keep constantly identifying the long run forcing variables from time to time. So they shouldn't depend on common studies. They must have their own empirical findings in order to have a sustainable financial institution development and then sustainable development. If I want to link this to sustainable development, actually, the purchasing power and the currency value, the exchange rate, has a relation with the saving that we use for investment. And to ensure sustainable development, we have to have a stable exchange rate. We have to have a stable exchange rate. And then if you have this, then we will be having a stable purchasing power. So the domestic saving, which is very high in Japan, compared with other East Asian countries, is helping for having money for all the investment and to ensure the sustainable development. So the key point here is exchange rate is very important for having sustainable financial resources. And I think if we have to have a good picture, we have to study the three gaps models. We have next paper should be based on exchange rate, saving and investment. Then we can show how is the sustainability of economic development. And please forgive me, this is not my area of specialization. And I'm just co-author and I forced to present it. I wish I did my best. Thank you very much for attention.